What is up, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Mumbly. Welcome back to another FIFA video. And today we're going to be talking about silver trading tips. We're going to be going over rare cards this time. So if you guys do enjoy the video, feel free to smack the like button. We got a couple different things on why rare cards, I believe, will go up in price. I'm just going to let you know this beforehand. It's already happened. We've seen it before in the past, so it's kind of repeating itself. If we go over to icons, we'll see that a lot of the icons are ending in 2 hours, and we're hopefully going to get new ones. What that means is we're going to get brand new teams where we get two of these. We get a Born Legends team where you need rare players exactly 11 bronzes, and then you need rare players exactly 11 silvers. So that causes rare prices to go up for players, especially top nations. So if you're looking at England, France, Brazil, England, Netherlands, Spain, those sort of things, they're going to be flying up in price. So what we're going to do is we're going to start bidding on kind of each position so we can get it done ourselves and then also have profit in order to make for other people. So let's go to silver commons real quick, or silver rares, I mean. Let's do France. Let's check the lowest buy now for France players right now. So currently, every France card sells for 300 coins within a half an hour. This is good news. That means you can bid on every single card you want for 250. You can just go in, place a bid. But we would probably be more specific. We'd probably do more defenders if we wanted to really cash out, because those tend to go up the most. But for the sake of this video, I'm just going to go through and place some bids. If you wanted to do a lowest buy now or compare price so you could trade in the moment as well, that's good. Remember too, you're going to get a lot of cards from top leagues as well. So if you're trading with French cards, you might get a lot of League One cards. If you want to compare prices for those, you can make a lot of coins off of seeing what their going rate is and maybe bid like up to 500, 600, or whatever it's going to. So if you want to be more specific too, another way you can do this method is going to Silver Rare. You can do center backs, see what center backs are going for in general. If we go to 300 coins for center backs, looks like everything's selling within the hour for the most part, but I don't see any good nationalities. So we're going to set a minimum buy now of 600 coins, max price 250. We're just going to kind of scroll through the pages and see if anything looks good. So we got these German and England players right there. They have bids on already. We have this Brazil player right there. Here's a German without a bid on him. So we're going to do that. Here's another German. Here's a Netherlands. It's basically that simple. So you're just going to want to do that. You're going to want to store a lot of these guys in the club. If in a couple hours we get the new icons, these guys' prices should go up quite a bit. I would say at least to 500 coins each. But if it's in a flipping solution, it's going to fly even more. So keep that in mind. I would do the same thing with rare bronzes as well. I don't know if you guys have ever traded with rare bronzes, but these are a really good investment because not many people are looking at them. So if we look at France, minimum buy now price 200 coins. Looks like every single French card again is selling within the hour for the most part. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bid 150 with a max minimum buy now, or not max, minimum buy now of 500 coins. We're just going to go through, bid 150 and store in our club for later. Again, this is more of an investment than a trading tip. The reason why it's more of an investment than a trading tip is you're not really going to see the instant profit as you would with other methods. If we did the typical silver center back where we bid 150 and flip for 300 coins, you can make coins quickly. This is just more of a short-term investment. If you think something's bound to come out, you can kind of beat the crowd who will go for buy now prices rather than bidding. So this is personally one of my favorites because you can sometimes win League One players without even realizing it. Sometimes you can win EPL players or championship players too if you're doing England. And yeah, that's basically it for that section. Let's take a look too at what other things could be coming out that would cause these prices to periodically go up throughout the days. We're gonna look at marquee matchups. Where's marquee matchups? I just woke up too, so if my voice sounds a little lower than it normally is, that's why. Okay, so for marquee matchups, lowest rated team you need in this is a 75, but there's no cap on golds, so you can use silvers for this. And it's La Liga players, players from the same club, max of 4, rare players minimum of 1. So I'm guessing if at the time this came out, you had any rare silver Spanish players, they probably went up a decent bit. So my advice would be kind of do this throughout the week. And every time a new SBC comes out, see, hey, is the price affected? Same thing with the loans. If we look at Traore, for his loan, you need a requirement of minimum silvers. So you need quite a few players on the team, 8 total. Spain players minimum of 1 and rare players minimum of 1. So again, if you had rare Spanish players in your club, you could have probably sold these on for quite a bit of coins. Same thing with the non-rares too. So not only is this a good idea to do with rare players, I would also be bidding 150 on non-rares from top nations as well and just kind of store them in the club. Kind of follows the filter of the 150 bidding center back method. And if you guys are still doing that, let me know if you're cashing out. I've taken a little break of it because I've been doing more league SBC focused content, but this is always fun. I started doing it again a little bit. Looks like most cards are going for 300 coins. You have some for 250, which still is guaranteed coins. So let's set up the filter real quick. Boom. This is also nice too with the league SBCs going away. We don't know if we're going to be getting the League One and or the Saudi back right away, or if we're going to see new league SBCs. Whatever the case is, this is always a good thing to do casually throughout the weeks and store in your club, because a lot of Liga NOS players you'll pick up, a lot of Chinese League players, a lot of Japanese League. I'm trying to think what other leagues might get it. Championship players. You have all these leagues, Eredivisie, that maybe don't have much value right now, but if their league SBC comes out, you can see a lot of these guys fly to 1,000 coins by now. So it's the easiest investment for me to make in the world, because even throughout the week, I'll go into my club and sell them on for more. So that's something to keep in mind. Same thing I'll be doing with the silver rare center backs. I'll just go in and for the most part, bid 250 on a bunch of center backs. And if, you know, we already have it and it's not going for much, we'll list it for 300, take the couple coins profit, but the rest we'll just kind of store in there. So I'm going to try to do that with each position as well. I'll go through left backs, I'll go through right backs, just so we have kind of a more complete club stock across the board. Yeah, I'm trying to think if there's another method I want to show you guys. So most of that was kind of based around icons when they come out, which hopefully we do have another set of icons soon. Let me know, what kind of icons are you guys looking to get? So for me, I have a little bit of, not an issue right now, but we lost a lot of coins on Mendy. We mass invested on Mendy. I don't know if you saw my coin total there, we're under 5 million. We lost about 900k on him. We bought 81 Mendys for like average 63k. And we sold a couple on for like 79k and then some for 70. And then his price just took a nosedive and he was down to like, I believe 50k at one point. What's he at now? Is he rebounding a little bit? Oh no. Okay, 59. Okay, 58. It's still relatively at the same price. So I took a nosedive on that, which I learned from that. I'm not going to do that in the future. If I am going to mass invest in higher rated cards, I'm going to do it with SBC fodder. So I'll do it with like 85 rateds, 86 rateds when they're at their lowest price. I'll just go all in on those instead. But no, that brings me to the point of my team. I would love to see them come out with some world-class defenders in icons. I would love to see some sort of another attacker. After team of the year, we are going to be building basically a full out icon team with whatever high rated untradeables we have. So I'm going to keep Neymar in, but like in FIFA 19, we had a full out icon team with all the best icons in the game. So my plan is to do the kind of same thing for you guys, show you how I grind those over time. And again, we are pack saving for team of the year. I'm currently at 237 packs. My goal is to be on 500. I definitely think that's doable. I just need to grind a lot more than I am currently. And one of those things that's going to help me is the three goals I had was 500 packs, 15 million transfer profit by team of the year, and then the other one was going to be 10 million liquid coins. Instead of 10 million liquid coins, what we're going to do is we're going to have a rule where we have to stay over 5 mil. But besides that, we can go all out for league SBCs. So in the meantime, what I'm going to do is going to get to like 5.5 mil, something like that. And for a lot of these league SBCs, we'll make a little bit of coins for them or break even. But I'm just going to make and make packs. so that we kind of always have stuff ready to go and that we can for sure, hopefully, you never guarantee it for sure, but I would love to pack a team of the year. So with that being said, thank you guys for watching. I'm excited to see what happens with not only the channel, but this grind soon. So if you guys want to stick around, if you're new, hit that sub button. If you guys did enjoy the video or found it helpful at all, feel free to hit that like button and keep an eye on the Icon SBCs. Anytime they release new ones, this works. Anytime there's new league SBCs, this sort of method works too. So it's kind of always good to do in the background. Remember, if you're investing in basically the lowest price you can for these, consider it fodder. It's not a really a risk. If you have to hold until it goes up in value, that's a good thing. I would recommend you have at least 25,000 coins to do this. Don't go broke and then be just holding on to everything. Kind of have your coins work for you. Since I'm going to be back over 5 million again, it makes sense for me to be doing something with it. So this is the something I'm going to be doing. Mass bidding on these and then mass bidding on League SBC cards. So I'll catch you guys later on stream. We'll be going over this more later. Yeah, I'll catch you then. It's Spinny Boy Mumbleet. I'm out. Peace.